Man, I love Hometown Takeover with Ben and Aaron. It was incredible because my wife and I used to work in Jackson, Mississippi. She's a pediatric ICU doctor. And we'd pass Laurel all the time. And then my wife loves these shows. We are into home remodeling. And I saw this show. And they're just so dynamic, so fun. And they love small hometowns, quaint hometowns. And it just really strikes me because that's where my passion comes in for being in Pascagoula, Mississippi. So I gotta tell you, my whole reason for doing something like this and petitioning HGTV comes down to a little bit of my story and just the entire story of Pascagoula, Mississippi. To share the 10,000 foot view, I am a doctor of pediatrics. I was recruited here over 5 years ago to a place that I didn't even know Pascagoula, Mississippi even existed. I did my residency in Mobile, Alabama, and what's unique about my story is I am an ex-28 weeker. I have had 16 surgeries. They told me I'd never walk, talk, or even be a doctor. I was brutally mistreated in medical school. I was rejected in different places, and the University of South Alabama picked you up for my residency. I've had the incredible privilege of having a couple books being printed. I'm a motivational speaker, and when I came here to this town, when I was recruited by Singing River Health System, the system in itself was going through its own unique growing changes, and I was charged with trying to revitalize the pediatric program. And so I took that on. I like broken things. I was told I'd never walk, talk, or even be a doctor. And I've learned that 10% of life is what happens to you and 90% is how you react to it. That people say no and God says yes. And so I took that burden, I took this opportunity, and I said, let me see what I can do with it. So I embarked on a complete radical change of the Sexton Health System in Pascagoula, Mississippi when it comes to pediatrics. And we have grown exponentially. We now serve the entire Gulf Coast and are doing it well and exceedingly. And in that, I became Pascagoula proud. I fell in love with this people. It is hometown. Blue collar, people just like me, and I've been wanting to serve. And I saw the need. I live by the motto, see a need, fill a need. And not only being a platform as a pediatrician for the community, I want my words to be more than just talk. So not only being ability to help kids and their families find the best care they can on the coast, I then looked for ways to impact and embark in improving our community. So I bought the local pool. It was a token or a staple of this community over 30 years ago. And I renamed it, called the H2O and Beyond Aquatic Center. I actually, crazy enough that I am, I bought it for 8 children from the school. They came up to me, they were patients of mine, they said, Dr. Sexton, they're gonna close down our swimming program because we have no place to swim because this local pool was very run down, financially in a bad way, and needed some revitalization. Well, I was filled with compassion because having cerebral palsy, I'm not your typical football player, basketball player, things like that. And so I said, well, let me try. And so I bought this pool because I was crazy and embarked on making some changes. And we did that. And so the pool's now been revitalized and opened for the past 2 years, but it desperately still needs some more help. I engaged in new filtration systems, painting, and all these different things for a place for the children. A place that kids and families can come for great family fun that is affordable for all the families. That then being said, I worked with the city and I started purchasing land off of tax liens, and I build houses, and I have a company called Lifehouse Homes, and so I build houses, we build houses, we rent them out, and we give some away for free when the opportunity arises. So I ended up becoming an entrepreneurial in terms of wanting to try to serve people and trying to keep this dream alive. I have a dream to create an arcade for the city of Pascagoula, a place for kids to come, kind of a nightclub for kids that they can come and have an arcade system, have a place to be, a pool, arcade, whatever it is. And we just think that I think that the passion of Ben and Aaron, the vision that they share in terms of revitalizing communities like Laurel, and I've had the privilege of meeting Jim Raspberry, his family, who was kind of associated with Ben and Aaron through the show. They've come down to Pascagoula and we've had to meet and just talk, and they've been a great relationship. I thought, why not try? Why not talk about trying to revitalize this? And what amazes me at Pascagoula, just like in my own life of resilience, when I say I can do something, it gets done. The people of Pascagoula are just as dynamic. We are resilient. If you would invest in us, if you would help impart a little bit of love and help us get kickstarted, we won't disappoint you. And we're gonna take something, we're gonna take a gift like this and we're gonna shine. We are titans of industry. We have Ingalls Shipbuilding here that builds all the ships, basically almost all the ships for the military. We have Chevron, Rolls-Royce builds some of their engines here. I mean, I was amazed at this little coastal town, which, you know, I love the seafood, love the personal touch everybody has, and I thought, wow, this is fantastic, and there's so much more here, and if we could just get a little facelift, people would be transformed.
Yes, and so, you know, one of the biggest issues of Pascagoula, or just Jackson County as a whole, we have all these industries and great places to work, but no one wants to live here. You know, are you thinking that this would help try to get people that work here to live here instead of going elsewhere?
I do. I think that this revitalization would show people that the town has a lot going for it, and it would bring more people in. You know, there's only 20 to 24,000 people that live in Pascagoula, but during the day, almost 100,000 people influx in because of these different titans of industry and these jobs they have. Between Ingalls being the number one, then Chevron, and then St. River Health System, our system is the major employer. And I think if they knew they had a place that they could come, be proud of, and a place for kids and their families to enjoy, from restaurants to entertainment centers to places where our community can gather and be a family, which is what we're all about in Pascagoula, Pascagoula Proud, they would come in and I think they would flood in by the numbers, and we would be able to nurture that and create something dynamic for the coast.